Cibola College President Dr. Sarah Clemens and the entire college welcome you to the Milton H. Johnson Health Center and Homecoming 2020. Tonight's game is a Panhandle Conference contest between the Tallahassee Eagles and your Cibola Indians. Let's meet the teams. First up on the visiting side, we have the Eagles. Starting for the Eagles, number one, Damian Stevens. Number three, L. Ellis. Number 11, Tariq Silver. Number 22, DeAndre Goldster. And number 23, Jordan Guest. Head coach of the Eagles, Zach Settembre.
Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to this broadcast of Cibola Basketball coming your way from the Milton H. Johnson Center here on the campus of Cibola Cox, Cibola College. I'm Clint Cox coming to you live as the Indians playing host to the Eagles of Tallahassee Community College. It is homecoming 2020. We'll get you the starting lineups as we're just underway. First shot is up. It's no good. Ball knocked out of bounds. It'll belong to the Eagles. For Cibola, we will start Mario Mading, number zero. David Pierce, number one. Christian Lauren, number 10. Lat Mayen, number 11. And Chris Gardner, number 22. The Eagles, who are dressed in royal blue uniforms with, I'll call that racing checkerboards on the sides of their pants and shirts. And they'll launch a three. It is no good. And the rebound goes to Lat Mayen of Cibola. For Tallahassee, they've got Davon Stevens, number one. L. Ellis, number three. Tariq Silver, number 11. DeAndre Golston, number 22. And Jordan Guest, number 23. That's your Eagles starters. Indians with the basketball. No score. David Pierce with the ball right now. Thought about a three. Now backs it out. Three on the shot clock. We got to get it off. We do. And it's nothing but net. Latt Mann with a pull-up three at the top of the key for three as the buzzer was sounding. Indians with the early 3-0 lead. And it will go without saying we are in a nearly must-win situation. We'll talk about why that is, but right now the Eagles have the basketball. Guest puts a three-pointer up. It's no good. Rebound, Christian Lauren for the Indians. Gardner will set up the offense for Chipola. Indians under the direction of Brendan Foley in his second season. They come in here with a record of 14 wins, 6 losses.
And
Mayan has the first 5 points for the Indians. Tallahassee with the basketball. Shot is up. No good, but we're going to have a whistle, and an Eagle will go to the free throw line shooting 2. So the Indians 14-6 overall, 2-2 in conference play. We started, we were 1-2 before going on the road Wednesday and getting a much-needed road victory, 68-61 over the Raiders at Northwest Florida State College, to even up at 2-2 after the first cycle of conference play. Tallahassee and Gulf Coast right now with 1 loss in conference play. And Eagles make 1, and so it is 5-1. Gulf Coast is 4-1. Tallahassee is 3-1 in conference play. On the men's side, pass underneath. This is Lauren with the ball. Nearly loses it. Indians will save it. 10 on the shot clock. Outlet pass to Pierce. He wants 3. It's good. David Pierce with the 3. And the Indians with an 8-1 lead. Good start for us. Eagles will lose it. Indians with the ball, and now we're going to have a kick ball called against Tallahassee. That's a bad break for the Indians because we had a fast break fixing to take off. They're actually calling a tripping. Instead of kicking the ball, he tripped. So the foul will go against DeAndre Golston. His first foul, first team foul against the Eagles. It'll be Chipola basketball. Gardner with it to set up the offense. Indians dressed in the gray uniforms, trimmed in Vegas gold. And again, the Eagles in the royal blue uniforms will go inside to Lauren. He lays it up and in. And the Indians looking very sharp here in the first 3.5 minutes of this contest. And I said, a much needed win for us tonight if we can get it. There's a 3 by the Eagles. It's no good, but we're going to have a foul. Foul's going to go against David Pierce. Got some subs getting ready to check in. If the Indians could get a win tonight, they would be 3-2 in conference play, and Tallahassee would fall to 3-2 in conference play. And I believe Gulf Coast is off tonight. And so if that were the case, then after 1 game into the second cycle, Tallahassee and Chipola would be 1 game behind Gulf Coast. A loss tonight puts us at 2-3, and the Eagles at 4-1. And needless to say, we don't need that.
Checking in for the Indians, number 4, Shaq Fay.
Tariq Silver makes 1 free throw to make it a 10-2 ball game. Shaq Fay checking into the game for Chipola. Where's number 4?
Find some energy. Pick it up.
Fay is out of the Senegal, 6'7" sophomore. Silver at the free throw line. He misses, so he makes 1 of 3, and the Indians get the rebound. and Gardner will set up the offense. Gardner over to Mayen. Hands it off to Fay. Hands it off to Mayen. 10 on the shot clock. Trying to get our offense set up. There's a pass underneath. Shot is up, no good. Rebound goes to the Eagles. And they want to run. Now they'll pull up and set up the offense. Mentioned that the Eagles are 3-1 in conference play. They are 19-3 overall. Looked like a travel, no call. Ball is knocked out of bounds, and it will belong to the Eagles, I believe. They'll reset the shot clock at 20. Eagles will inbound the basketball right in front of the Chipola bench. Nearly stolen, and it nearly was stolen, but Tallahassee got it right back. Little head fake, shot is up. No, they're going to wave it off and say he traveled. Little hop skip that time by the Eagles. Silver will check out of the game. Golston will check in. Eagles are under the direction of Zach Set. I'll have to find out how he pronounces that name. Settenbury, I believe is how that goes. Indians with the basketball. Fay with it up top, working it around the perimeter. There's a drive to the basket. Shot is up, no good. Loose ball. Indians come up. Gardner, pull-up jumper. No good. Rebound goes to the Eagles. Got a foul underneath against the Eagles. Eric Hester picking up the foul. Eshaun White will check into the game for Chipola. Christian Long will check out. So we've got Mating, Mayen, White, Gardner, and Fay on the floor. This is Fay up top. He wants three. It's good. Sheck Fay gives us a 13-2 lead as we played 5.5 minutes in this contest. Not the start the Eagles were looking for, I'm sure, but the homecoming crowd here at the Milton Ace Johnson Center are delighted. Three-point shot, no good by the Eagles. Shot put back is good, the second go-round. Miguel had a chance at it, couldn't get it to fall. And following up with the bucket was Golston. Gardner with it up top. Goes inside to White, his shot is up, it's good, and he's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line, try to make a three-point play the old-fashioned way.
Count the bucket for the Indians. Fouls number 22 for the Eagles. That's his second. Team's third. At the line for the Indians, number 13, Eshaun White. Shooting the ball on us.
White's free throw is up. It is good. And he gives Chipola a 16-4 lead. Eshaun White out of Mox Comer, South Carolina. 6'7" freshman for the Indians. Eagles with the basketball. Good pressure defense by Chipola. Nearly thrown away by the Eagles. 8 on the shot clock. Hester with the ball. Works it inside. Pull up jumper off the mark. Loose ball picked up by the Eagles. They'll get another 20 seconds on the shot clock. And Ellis will set up the offense. Indians will commit the foul. Eshaun White with the little bump.
Foul number 13 for the Indians.
Lance Irving checking into the game for Chipola. Checking out will be Mario Mading. Lance Irving out of Leesburg, Florida, 6'3" freshman. Eagles with a fresh 20 on the shot clock, and Ellis will bring it down. Guarded closely by Gardner. They'll go underneath, reverse layup, no good. Rebound, Indians. Fay to Irving. Now we'll set up the offense. Gardner with it up top. 16-4. Into the corner for three. Good. Check Fay with the bucket. Fay out of the Senegal. He is 6'7", but he shoots threes like a small point guard. 19-4 as we've nearly played 8 minutes in this first half. There's a three by Tallahassee. It's off the mark, but they get the rebound. And they'll set up the offense. Golson driving. There's some collision. And they're going to call charging against the Eagles. Tariq Silver will check back into the game for the Eagles. Checking out of the game is Golston as he has picked up three fouls. And we haven't even gotten to the midway point of the first half. Gardner to Mading. Up top, looking for help. None there. Now over to Fay. Fay driving to the paint. Now pull-up jumper. No good. Rebound, Eagles. Ellis will bring it down. Stolen by the Indians. Irving will drive the length of the floor. Slam dunk. Six-foot-three out of Leesburg. He slammed that one like he was 6'7". It is 21-4. Indians with the lead. Silver with it. Guarded by Fay. Driving, now kicks it off. Three-pointer by the Eagles is up and good. First three of the game by the Eagles makes it 21-7 as we near the halfway mark of the first half. Gardner with the ball out front into the corner to Irving. Driving, dishes it to White, slammed up. Nice ball movement that time by the Indians, 23-7. Eagles with the basketball. Gardner on defense for Chipola. We got him out near the midcourt line. He'll dish it around the horn. This is Stevens. Now to the corner for three. That was Hester with the missed shot. Indians with the rebound. Gardner to Fay. Gardner driving into White. His shot is up. Good. Eshawn White. 25-7. Indians with the lead. Eagles go inside to one of their big men. Some contact. No call. Shot is up and good. Griffin Miguel with the bucket for the Eagles. Three-point shot, no good by the Indians, but we get the rebound. Gardner, he wants three, no good. Back-to-back threes, but the Eagles will throw it away and will get a third try. Here's the pass to Irving. His shot is no good, but he is fouled, hammered hard by the Eagles. He'll go to the free throw line, and I believe we may have a timeout on the floor. Media timeout on the floor. We'll take it with them. 9:07, Indians leading, leading 25-9.
Drayson Smith. If you're still with us, come on down to the scores table. We picked you to shoot the half-court shot at our next media timeout. Drayson Smith, please come to the scores table.
Ready to get back underway with 9:07 to play. We just got an update. DeAndre Golston now with two fouls and Eric Hester with two fouls. Earlier they had Golston with three. That has been changed now, and passing that on to you at the line is Lance Irving. First free throw is up and good.
That line for the Indians, number two, Lance.
26-9. The score. Make it 27-9 as Irving hits both of them. We've played 11 minutes here in this first half, and it's been, at least in my view, the best first half so far for the Indians during the conference schedule this year. They have played extremely well. Eagles with the basketball. We just got the stat sheet. Look at that, and there's a travel against the Eagles. Rebounding fairly even. Indians with 8. Eagles with 7. Eagles have got 4 turnovers. We have just 1 in 11 minutes of play. How about now 2? I guess I jinxed us right there. Talking about turnovers, and we got one. Indians so far in the first half have shot 59% from the field. Tallahassee, 25%. Eagles with the basketball. Thought about a three, now they'll go back inside. Working his way in there and putting the shot up is Guest, but his shot is no good. And he'll go to the other end of the floor as the ball will belong to Chipola. And I believe we're going to have to stop that as one official was getting some subs in. The other official had thrown the ball in.
Go! Lead up, Eric! Come on, Eric! Lead up!
Indians get it across half court to Gardner underneath. And shot is blocked by the Eagles. That was Anthony Higgs with the shot for Chipola. And the Eagles want 3. They don't get it. Higgs comes up with a rebound. Indians wanting to run. We'll go underneath and reverse layup, no good. Put back is good by Mating. And we got a Eagle down on the floor. Warning issued against the Tallahassee bench. Coach Settembrie, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, been very vocal in this first half. I think that would be putting it mildly. His team has struggled, so some of that vocalization directed towards his team, but some of it directed towards the men wearing the striped shirts tonight. 20-point lead for the Indians. 7:26 to play in the first half. Eagles with the ball. Driving, now pulling up at the line. And I don't think that got off in time. And the rebound. Boy. Let's see what they rule right here. I thought the shot clock had expired. They're going to say it had not by the time the shot was issued. We got the rebound, but we tripped or stumbled, went out of bounds, and it'll belong to Tallahassee. They get 20 on the shot clock, approaching the 7-minute mark of the first half. And now we got a whistle and a foul underneath. Foul is going to go against Christian Lorne. That's his first foul. 14 fouls on Chipola. Eagles will inbound the ball. We knock it away. It'll go out of bounds and will belong to the Eagles. Eagles trailing our Indians by 20 points. Four on the shot clock. They'll get it underneath. We'll strip it away. Nice hands by Lance Irving to strip it away from the big man, Jordan Guest of Tallahassee. Gardner will set up the offense for the Indians. Over to Irving. Trying to go inside. Higgs puts a shot up. No good. Rebound, Tallahassee. Hester brings it down. A big step back. Crowd wanted trembling. Men in Stripes said no. We've got the ball anyway. Mating, driving, pull-up jumper. No good. Loose ball goes out of bounds. They'll say last touch by the Eagles. It'll be Tallahassee's. Tallahassee will be on defense. And another media timeout taken with 5:53 to play in the first half. And our Indians leading 29-9.
So we have his Tyronza Smith is going to shoot for him.
So this is going to be the half-court shot. If they make it, they get a free TV. Comes up a little bit short.
I'd like to thank Badcock Home Furniture and more of Graceville for giving us a chance to shoot for a 50.
With just under 6 minutes to play in the first half. Indians out rebounding the Eagles 12-10. Turnovers, they've got five, we've got two. Shooting percentage has dropped just a little bit for us. We were shooting 58%, now shooting 50%. But it's dropped for Tallahassee as well. They're shooting 18% on the night from the field. Indians 4 of 7 from beyond the three-point line, 3 of 3 from the free throw line. Tallahassee 2 for 5 from the charity stripe and 1 of 9 from beyond the three-point arc. Indians will inbound the basketball in the corner right in front of the Tallahassee bench. They do so to Gardner. Fay with the basketball. Now to Lorne. Back to Gardner. 5 on the shot clock. Driving, dishes it to Lorne, and his slam dunk is good. He's got 4 points in the first half, and he gives the Indians a 31-9 lead with just under 5.5 to play in the first half. Eagles want 3. They'll get it. Tariq Silver with a 3. He's got 4 points in the half. And Tallahassee just now into double digits at 12 as we've got 5 minutes on the clock. Mayan to Gardner to Fay. Mating tries to go underneath to Lorne. A little bit too low on the bounce pass. Goes out of bounds, belongs to Tallahassee. Ellis to Silver. Driving. And we're going to have a foul against Chipola. Foul's going to go against Chris Gardner. Tried to come up with a steal. Couldn't get it. Whistle for the foul. Tariq Silver will go to the free throw line. He's out of Clarksville, Tennessee. 6'5" sophomore. First free throw is up and good. Got 5 points in the first half. Makes them both. And makes it 31-14. Indians with the lead. Inside, Mating. Bank shot. 4 points on the game for Marielle. 33-14, Indians with the lead. Eagles want three, they got them. Eagles starting to heat up a little bit. It's 33-17. Pull up jumper by the Indians is good. Mayan. He's got 7 points here in the first half. Eagles with the ball. Hill with it. Driving. Dishes it outside. They'll work it around the horn. There's a three-pointer. It's up and good by Jordan Gist. And the 20-point lead we had is down to 15. 3.5 to play in the first half. Foul by the Eagles. Neither team in the bonus situation yet. So Chipola will inbound the basketball on the sideline right in front of some of those hometown folks here that have come out. Good crowd on hand tonight for homecoming. Indians with only one home game on Saturday night in the conference schedule. And the good news is next year we should have five home games on Saturday night. Indians with the missed shot. Eagles with it. They want three. They change their mind. Now they want three. Can't get it. And they get the rebound. Another three is up and good. Silver now getting heated up for Tallahassee. He's got 9 points in the first half. It's 35-23. Irving picks up the dribble. Cross-court pass to Fay. Up top to Irving. Tries to go down low. 8 on the shot clock. And double dribbling against the Indians. Lat Mayan. 2:23 to play in the first half. It's a 12-point lead for Chipola. Eagles want three, won't get it. Indians with the ball. Irving pushing it down the floor. He'll dish it off, lay it up and in. That is Mayan with the bucket. Eagles shot up, no good. We've got the rebound. And Coach Foley says, slow it down. That was a big bucket on the fast break, but now we want to work the clock a little bit. Gardner inside to Lorne. His shot no good, but he's fouled. That was a really nice pass that time to get the ball down low to Lorne. But his momentum kind of carried him a little bit further under the goal than I think he wanted to be. We're fortunate he got fouled and goes to the free throw line with 1:40 to play in the first half. First free throw is up and no good. A couple of subs coming in for Tallahassee. Riffin Miguel is into the game, along with Eric Hester. For Chipola, we've got Gardner, Irving, Lorne, Fay, and Mayan on the floor. Eagles now facing some pressure by the Indians. They break that pressure into the corner. Now driving, loose ball. Indians come up with it. This is Irving with the ball on the wing, driving, lays it up. It's no good, and we're going to have a foul against the Indians. Christian Lorne whistled for the foul.
Foul's number 10 for the Indians.
16 fouls now on Chipola, so Tallahassee not in the bonus yet. Eshaun White going to check into the game for Chipola. Played very well earlier on for the Indians. He's got 7 points in that early play for Chipola. Nearing the 1 minute mark of the first half. Ellis with the ball out front for Tallahassee. Over to Stevens. Loses it momentarily, gets it back, and hands it right back to Ellis with 5 on the shot clock. Drive, oh, he traveled. I know they let him do a little bit of NBA here sometimes, but even that one had to get the whistle for traveling. Nice defense by Chipola, I believe, calls that travel. Indians will face some pressure. We break that pressure. And now we get it down. This is Irving driving, puts a shot up, no good, but he's fouled. Foul's going to go against Calix Stevens of Tallahassee. It'll send Lance Irving to the free throw line. Lance, 6'3", freshman out of Leesburg. First free throw is up and no good. Went to the free throw line a little while ago, was 2 for 2. See if he can't make this one right here and give us a 16-point lead. Right now we lead by 15. Can't get it to fall, so we miss them both. And the Eagles will have the basketball. About 6 seconds difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Eagles looking inside, nothing there. Now they want 3, it's no good. Rebound, Gardner for Chipola to Fay. 15 on the shot clock, or the game clock. There's a little floater, we can't get it to fall. Eagles will get the basketball back with 8 seconds. There's a drive, we knock it away, and they're gonna call a foul. And that's going to be a costly foul for us because it's going to send a Eagle to the free throw line with 4 seconds to play in the first half. Eric Hester will go to the free throw line to shoot the 1-1. Hester out of Clearwater, Florida, 6'3" sophomore. Fifteen-point lead for the Indians. Hester can cut it to 13 with a couple of free throws. Makes the first. He'll have another coming. And he makes both free throws to make it a 13-point lead for Chipola with 4 seconds to play. Tallahassee going to put some pressure on the inbound pass. And we'll get it in. And they'll nearly come up with a steal, but that will do it for the first half. Indians leading 38-25. We'll have the homecoming court presentation coming up, and we'll send you over to Matt White and the gang for that. And then we'll come back in just a few moments with second half action.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Homecoming 2020. Chipola's got that 2020 vision. We have a very special group who returned this year, some of them for their 50th anniversary of attending Chipola College. Will the group from the class of 69, 70, and 71 please stand? Are y'all here? Where are you guys? Can we see you? Well, anyway, Suzanne Jaeger organized this group, and they came back to see Chipola, and they were very sad to see how many trees were missing from our beautiful campus, so they collected over $2,000 to give to the Chipola Foundation for us to buy more trees. So let's have a big hand for the class of 69, 70, and 71. Thank you, guys. All right, at this time, we would like to ask all alumni of Chipola to please stand. If you graduated from Chipola, would you please stand up? If you didn't graduate because of college algebra, or maybe English or humanities, but you took classes, please stand up. All right, there's a lot more of those. All right, well, thank you all for coming back, and we appreciate our alumni so much. The winners of our homecoming talent show were third place Allie Williams, second place Aaron Welch and Morgan Johnson, and first place Michael Anthony Brown. In our homecoming building decoration contest, the honors program was third, the Trio Society was second, and the Black Student Union won first place. All right, and now our homecoming court. Our first freshman attendant is Georgia Cloud, sponsored by the Student Government Association. She's the daughter of Ricky and Tracy Cloud of Sneeds. She's a member of the Student Government Association and Student Ambassadors. Georgia enjoys babysitting, traveling, friends and family, and going to Disney. She is majoring in speech pathology and plans to transfer to Florida State to earn a degree. She is escorted by freshman Bailey Rich, sponsored by Phi Beta Kappa. He's the son of Dwight and Heather Rich of Bonifay. Bailey leads a small group at his church, and he's active in Phi Beta Kappa. He plans to transfer to Florida A&M University to major in pharmacy. Ladies and gentlemen, Georgia Cloud and Bailey Rich. Our second freshman attendant is Kiara Denon, sponsored by Trio Society. She's the daughter of Christian Daughtry and Mariana. She's involved in Trio, and she enjoys cooking, spending time with family and friends, and being successful. She's a nursing major and plans to transfer to Florida State to become a pediatrician. She is escorted by Ezekiel Blunt, sponsored by the Trio Society. He's the son of Andrell and Tammy Blunt and Mariana. He's active in Trio and enjoys meeting new people and making memories. He's an architecture major and interior design major and plans to transfer to FAMU. Let's hear it for Kiara Denon and Christian Daughtry. Oh, I'm sorry, and Ezekiel Blunt. Our first sophomore candidate for Homecoming Queen is Mary Beth Brown, sponsored by the Student Scientists Association. She's the daughter of Doyle and Beth Brown of Hosford. She's Student Ambassador President, ACE Lab Tutor, Phi Theta Kappa VP, Cross Country Runner, VP of the Student Scientists, and a member of the Pre-Med Society Honors and Mu Alpha Theta. She enjoys reading the Bible, baking, going to the beach, hunting, and fishing. Mary Beth's an exercise physiology major and plans to transfer to Florida State to pursue a career in the medical field. She's escorted by Caleb Cooley, sponsored by the Honors Program. He's the son of Anthony and Rachel Cooley of Bonifay. He's active in Pre-Med Society and Honors. Caleb enjoys sports, video games, and attending church. Caleb plans to attend Florida State to earn a bachelor's degree in exercise physiology. He hopes to transfer to the University of Florida to become an occupational therapist. Mary Beth Brown and Caleb Cooley. Our second sophomore candidate for Homecoming Queen is Aaliyah Everett, sponsored by Trio Society. She's the daughter of Christopher and Simeon Everett of Bluntstown. She's active in cross country, cheerleading, Black Student Union, and is vice president of Trio. Aaliyah is majoring in communication. graduation and plans to transfer to Florida A&M to become a sports broadcaster. She's escorted by Brett Finney, sponsored by the Student Government Association. He's the son of Tony and April Finney of Bluntstown. He's a member of student government, student scientists, and student ambassadors. Brett enjoys golfing, playing guitar, hunting, fishing, and hanging with friends. He's an exercise physiology major and plans to transfer to Florida State and go on to become a chiropractor. Ladies and gentlemen, Aaliyah Everett and Brett Finney. The third sophomore candidate for Homecoming Queen is Isley Patterson Rose, sponsored by the cheerleaders. She's the daughter of April Patterson and Marcus Rose of Mariana. She's active in Trio, Black Student Union, and cheerleading. Isley enjoys spending time with family and friends. She's a communication disorders major and will transfer to Florida State University. She's escorted by sophomore Tamarick Jones, sponsored by Phi Beta Kappa. He's the son of Katina Baker and Reginald Jones of Mariana. Tamarick is active in Phi Beta Kappa, Mu Alpha Beta, student government, and honors. He enjoys going on long drives, reading poetry, bird watching, and volunteering at nursing homes. He's a pre-med major and plans to transfer to the University of Florida to earn a degree so he can open his own medical practice. Ladies and gentlemen, Isley Patterson Rhodes and Tamarick Jones. And now we'd like to introduce last year's homecoming queen and Mr. Chipola. Tajani Baker is the daughter of Tammy Garrett and George Baker of Mariana. She's a junior at Florida A&M majoring in public relations. Michael Ingram is the son of Crystal Stokes and Michael Ingram of Bluntstown. He's a junior at Florida State majoring in interdisciplinary social science. We're happy to welcome back Tajani and Michael to Chipola to give away their crown and Mr. Chipola medallion. At this time, Michael Ingram has the honor of placing the medallion on the new Mr. Chipola and the 2020 Mr. Chipola is Tamarick Jones. Tamarick's the son of Katina Baker and Reginald Jones of Mariana. He's a pre-med major planning to transfer to the University of Florida, and he hopes to become a doctor and open his own medical practice. Mr. Chipola, Tamarick Jones. And now, we will have the crowning of the new homecoming queen. Chipola President Dr. Sarah Clemens will assist with this, along with Tajani Baker, our 2019 homecoming queen. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2020 Chipola College homecoming queen is Isley Patterson Rose. Isley's the daughter of April Patterson and Marcus Rhodes of Mariana. She's a communication disorders major planning to transfer to Florida State. Let's have another round of applause for our new Mr. Chipola, Tamarick Jones, and homecoming queen, Isley Patterson Rhodes, and our entire 2020 Chipola homecoming court.
And we're ready to get started with second half action. Clint Cox coming to you live from the Milton H. Johnson Center here on the campus of Chipola College, Robert Trammell Court. Indians playing host to Tallahassee. It is homecoming, and the news good right now. Indians with a 13-point lead, 38-25. Eagles will start with the basketball. They are dressed in the royal blue uniforms. Indians in the gray uniforms trimmed in Vegas gold. Eagles go inside, and right off the bat, they get a bucket. And that is Calix Stevens with the bucket. Gardner with it for Chipola. And Indians going to get whistled for a traveling infraction. Eagles will have the basketball. Let's go. At a half time, Taylor. Eagles with the ball. Out front. Looking inside. Nothing there. And a 3-second lane violation against the Eagles. We'll give it to Chipola. Indians with the lead. Gardner driving. Shot is up. It's good. Gardner with 6 points on the game. Eagles working it around the perimeter. Now there's a drive to the basket. Shot is up, no good. Loose ball put back by Tallahassee. No good. Blocked by Chipola, and the Indians come up with the rebound. Gardner with the ball. Looks inside, nothing there. Now dishes it over to Pierce. Long two shot, no good. Rebound. Eagles. And there's a three from Stevens, and he's got 5 points, all of them in the second half. There's a drive, shot blocked by the Indians. Lauren comes down with the basketball. Layup is good. Lat Mayen with the bucket. He's got 11 on the night. Played nearly 3 minutes here in this second half. It's a 12-point lead by the Indians. No more. It is a 9-point lead. First time the Eagles have been within single digits in quite some time. Since early in the first half. Eagles driving, shot is up, no good. Shot was partially blocked on the putback. Eagles still got the ball, and there's a bucket. Golston with the bucket. He's got 5 in the game now. And it is a 7-point lead. Indians want 3, we'll get them. Big shot from Gardner. He's got 9 on the night. And makes it a 10-point Chipola lead as we near the 16-minute mark of the second half. Eagles with the basketball. They want 3. Won't go. And the Indians with the rebound. Gardner to Irving underneath, and it is stolen by the Eagles, but they lose it. Shot is up. No good by the Indians. And the Eagles get the rebound. Three by Tallahassee is good.
Number 11, Derek Silver, 4-3.
Silver with the bucket. And a timeout called by Tallahassee as they've got it back to a 7-point game. Last Wednesday night, got a big 68-61 road victory to even their conference record at 2-2, 14-6 overall, and we have led the entire night against the Eagles, but they have clawed their way back and made it a 7-point game. But there is a three by David Pierce. He's got six on the night and gives us the 10-point lead. We'd love to see us pull out again, and you knew the Eagles were going to make a run, but see if we couldn't respond to that and push it out to another big lead and see if they can battle back from that. There is a finger roll off the hand of Latin Man. It's good, and he will get a free throw. DeAndre Golston picks up his third. And Latt Mahan will go to the free throw line. 6'9", redshirt sophomore out of Australia. And he makes the free throw. And he's got 12 on the night. 51-38, Indians with the lead. A dish underneath. Ball knocked away, but the Eagles get it right back and put it in to make it an 11-point lead for Chipola, 51-40. Gardner will throw it away. Thought Pierce was coming out. Pierce was breaking towards the basket. And a turnover will give it to Tallahassee. Ellis handling the ball. Hands it off to Guest. To Silver. Driving, pull up jumper is good. This guy can shoot. He's got 14 on the night. Had 9 at the half. 6 so far in the second half. Gardner with a basketball for Chipola out front. Over to Pierce. To Mahan. He wants three. It's good. Lat Mahan with 15 points on the night. And he gives Chipola a 12-point lead. We led by 13 at the half. Three by Tallahassee, no good. Loring with the rebound. Gardner will set up the offense for Chipola. Over to Mahan. To Loring, and gonna have a foul against the Eagles. And the foul's against Jordan Guest. That'll be his second foul. Eshaun White into the game for Chipola. So we've got White, Fay, Gardner, Mahan, and Pierce on the floor. Guest will come out. Miguel will check in for him for the Eagles. So for the Eagles, they've got Calix Stevens, Tarek Silver on the floor. L. Ellis, Eagles with the steal. Down the floor, Chipola will come up with a steal. Mahan, and now there's a collision and a blocking foul against Tallahassee.
Foul number
L. Ellis picking up the foul, his first. Lance Irving into the game for Chipola. Gardner will check out. Irving to Mayen. Back to Irving. To White. To Irving. And now we got an issue, I believe, with the clock. And they're going to come over and get the clock squared away. Not sure if it was the game clock or the shot clock, but. So they are running the game clock down to 12:43 and 18 on the shot clock. Mayen will inbound it for the Indians, does so to Irving. Irving to Fay, drive, pull up jumper, no good. And now we got a whistle and a foul. And it's gonna go against Tarek Silver. So Fay to the free throw line. First free throw is up and good. He's got seven on the night. Fay out of the Senegal, 6'7" sophomore. David Pierce on the floor, 6'3" sophomore out of St. Petersburg. Eshawn White, 6'7" freshman out of Mox Comer, South Carolina. And Lance Irving, 6'3" freshman out of Leesburg. That's your Indians on the floor right now. Tallahassee with the basketball. There's a drive. They'll kick it out. Three-point shot is no good. And we'll have a whistle and a foul underneath.
Foul's number 11 for the Indians. His first, team first.
So we lead by 14, and the Eagles inbound the basketball. A drive, shot missed by the Eagles, rebound White for Chipola. Defay back to Irving. He wants three, he's got him. Lance Irving with the three. From the top of the key. 7 points on the game for Irving, and it is back to a 17-point lead. We led by as many as 20 in the first half, and we've led by as few as seven. There's a drive, shot no good by the Eagles. Ball is won by the Indians. Mayen came down with a rebound, now we'll lose it. Silver down the floor, his pass to Eric Hester. And he gets the layup, and it's 59-44. The Indians with the lead. Three from Pierce, no good. Rebound, Eagles. Stevens to the paint, now kicks it out to Silver. Goes back to Stevens, he can't hang on to it. Turnover gives it to Chipola, pushing it down the floor, and Tallahassee will have to foul.
Foul number 33 for the Eagles, his second, team fifth, media timeout.
Media timeout on the floor with 10:29 to play. Indians leading 59. We're ready to get back underway here from the Robert Trammell Court here at the Milton Johnson Center on the campus of Chipola College in Marianna, Florida. Clay Cox coming to you live. Lance Irving at the free throw line shooting two. First one is up and good by Irving. Lance with 8 points on the night now. They get nine. Makes both free throws and makes it 61-44. Tallahassee sets up the offense. And there's a three-pointer. Hill with the bucket. His first points of the night. Lady Indians fall tonight to the visiting Lady Eagles of Tallahassee. We were 4-1 entering the game, so 4-2 now. That was the first conference win of the season for Tallahassee. Lead Gulf Coast off tonight. And Pensacola Northwest doing business, I believe. Missed shot by the Eagles. And they're going to say that the ball belongs to Chipola. And we're going to have a technical against Tallahassee.
Technical foul on the Eagles.
Coach Zach Settembry, if I'm pronouncing that right, in his first full season as head coach, took over midway through the conference season last year when the Tallahassee coach chose to move on. First free throw is up and good by Mayan. He'll have another one coming. And he makes them both. Mayan now with 17 points to lead the Indians and actually lead all scorers. And the Indians get the basketball and they'll bring it down. Indians working it around the perimeter. Three-point shot, no good. White battling for the ball for Chipola, can't come up with it. It'll belong to Tallahassee. And 9 minutes to play in the contest. Eagles go inside, and we got a foul against going to be against David Pierce. David Pierce picks up his third foul, and the Eagles will get the basketball and a fresh 20 on the shot clock. Eagles with the basketball right here in front of the scorer's table. Three-point shot is no good. Rebound Indians. And we'll have a foul. They're going to call a charge against Chipola. Didn't see that one, but so the Eagles have the basketball. They want three. They won't get it. White comes up the rebound for Chipola. We really need not be in any hurry. Leading 63-47. Need to milk that clock each time just a little bit. We want three. We don't get that. Nice rebound by White. Goes in. Slam dunk. Hello, Montcomer, South Carolina. How about the Gamecocks? I don't know if he's a Gamecock fan or not, but it sounded good to me anyway. Sounded like the right thing to say. Maybe I need to check into that. See if he's a Gamecock fan. Indians with the steal. Irving shaking, baking, drives. Shot is up. It's good. He's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. It's a 20-point lead for Chipola. DeAndre Robinson picking up the foul. I believe Tallahassee calling for a timeout. They will. And Irving will go to the free throw line to shoot one when the timeout's over. Timeout is over. 7:20 to play in the second half.
Lance Irving
at the free throw line trying to make a three-point play after the layup and the foul, and it clangs in and clangs out. And we'll hold with a 20-point lead, 67-47. And foul against the Indians will send an Eagle to the free throw line.
Foul number 10 for the Indians is third, team's fourth. At line for the Eagles, number 22, DeAndre Golston.
Golston will go to the free throw line, shooting two. He is out of Gary, Indiana. I believe Gary, Indiana is where Michael Jackson's family was from. Many, many years ago. First free throw is up and no good. Golston, a 6'5" sophomore. And he makes one of two. He's got 6 points on the night, does Golston. 67-48, Indians with the lead. Fay with it to Mating, who's checked into the game. Shot off the mark, Tallahassee with the rebound. They want three. And they don't get the three, but two Indians go for the rebound. They can't come up with it. And Silver grabs the rebound, puts it back in. He's got 16. And he makes it a 17-point lead for Chipola. Timeout is over. After the made bucket by the Eagles, Indians with the 17-point lead with 6:40 to play in the second half. Mario Mading will inbound the basketball for Chipola. Just so to Gardner, right back to Mading, to Irving, and we break the pressure down the floor to Fay. He lays it up and in.
Basketball number four, Shep Fay.
That is just the way you draw it up. 10 points for Fay, but we come right back down. And Silver hits a three, he's got 19. Driving to the bucket is Irving. He's got 13. Tempo picking up just a little bit here. Three by Tallahassee, it's good. Ellis with 11 on the night now. And the team's in a shooting flurry here the last three times down. There's a drive, dishes it to Loring. He can't hang on to it. Tallahassee comes up with it. Eagles, there's a spin move. And foul is gonna go against Tallahassee. Golston,
that's his fourth.
That should be his fourth. We got a media timeout on the floor with 5:39 to play. Indians. Timeout is over. Indians to inbound the basketball. We get it in and we get it across the half court line. We want three. We got them. Shaq Fay with the bucket. He's got 13 on the evening. Three by Tallahassee, no good. Rebound goes to the Indians. And we'll set up the offense. Maybe work that clock a little bit. They're gonna double team the ball. Gardner with it now in the corner. It goes, driving, slam dunk by Lat Mayen. 19 points on the evening for Mayen. Three by Tallahassee is good. L. Ellis with the bucket. 76-59, we thought about a three. Now we'll work it a little bit. And we're gonna have a moving screen called against Chipola's Christian Lorne. And so with 4:35 to play in the contest, we lead by 17. Eagles with the basketball. Drive, shot up, no good by Lorne. And Gardner will walk it down. Should be able to get under 4 minutes on this possession. We want three, we can't get it. Eagles with the basketball. They want three, they can't get it. We come up with a rebound. 3:50 to play in the contest. Gardner to Fay, he drives and that's gonna be a charge against the Indians. Golston got the feet set, felt the contact, went to the floor. And that will give the ball to the Eagles. Pass again, let's go. Hunt, hunt, hunt. Ellis brings it down. Over to Silver. There's a drive, loose ball on the floor. We come up with it. Mayan. Now we'll bring it outside. Now we'll work his way over. Thought about a three. We drive. We pull it back out. We want three now. Gardner, no good. There's a drive by the Eagles. Shot is up and good by Ellis. Okay, correct that. That was Yahel Heal. The homecoming crowd here with 3:01 to play. And Chipola leading 76-61. Eagles come up with the steal. That is Guess with it. Over to Hester. Down low. To Ellis, goes out of bounds. It will belong to Tallahassee.
Checking in for the Indians, number zero, Mariel Mading.
Mariel Mading checking into the game for Chipola. Check Fay will check out of the game. Eagles inbound it. Three-pointer, no good. Goes out of bounds. Heal launched it, but came up short. Gardner will bring it down for Chipola. And we're just milking the clock right now. 10 on the shot clock. We didn't milk it enough, but 2:10 to play. Eagles with the basketball. They want three. No good. Ball tipped around. One by Tallahassee.
Stevens
with the bucket. That makes it a 13-point game with 2 minutes to play. Exactly 2 minutes to play. Chipola will inbound the basketball. And we do so to Gardner. He'll get it to Mading. Back to Gardner, to Mading. And we get it across half court. And Gardner driving, kicks it out to Pierce. Works it underneath, no good, rebound. Indians, but we lose the basketball. Eagles with it. They thought about a three. Now they drive. Shot is up. It's good. And
the
we commit the foul.
Foul number 0 for the Indians. First, key 7, bonus.
So now the Eagles will be in the bonus. But they would get the free throw here anyway because the foul on the shot. They can cut it to a 10-point game with the made free throw. And that's exactly what they do. Ellis with 17 points, but down the floor, mating with the dunk. And it's 78-66. Spin move into the corner for three. Good. Hill with the three. He's got 6 points on the night. And Tallahassee calls their last timeout. Lap Mahan will inbound the basketball for Chipola. Does so to Irving. We'll get it to Pierce, cross the half court line. And while we're shooting, I have no idea. We didn't really have the shot, and we didn't milk the clock at all, but we did get the ball back. And Irving to inbound it. Looking. And the ball is tipped out of bounds. Last touch by an Eagle. Got to credit Tallahassee. They've been down by as many as 20. They have battled hard, never gave up. And we get it across half court. Cross court pass.
No, Eric. Got it, 8.
And Hester picks up the foul. And it'll be a 1-1. Yes, 1-1 as we are not in the double bonus yet. So Mating will go to the free throw line. And the first one's up and good by Marielle. He's got 7 points on the night. He can give us an 11-point lead with 46 seconds left. And he does just that. Eagles 3, no good. Rebound, Indians. Gardner. Ball nearly stolen, but Pierce comes away with it. And now we can kind of just let the clock run a little bit. Might even take a shot clock violation. Gardner will probably throw one up. That's exactly what he does. Ball clanged around, did not go in. Eagles with one last shot, they make it.
Final score, Eagles 72, Indians 80.
And that'll do it for Chipola. They get the 80-72 win. They'll be back in action on Wednesday when they host Pensacola. Ladies at 5:30, men at 7:30. For the Indians tonight, Lat Mahan led the way with 19 points. Chek Fay and Lance Irving with 13 apiece. For Tallahassee, They were led by Tariq Silver with 22 points and L. Ellis with 17 points. I want to thank the gang from CCTV, their usual great job. Our time is up. We thank you for yours. I'm Clint Cox saying so long, sports fans.